Yeah. Find me on the cliffside. All they do is overlook me. Yeah. If things don't pan out, keep it cooking. Hey, what's up, guys? Henry the Blasian here, and as you can see in front of you today, we've got the brand new 96 overall Pink Diamond Sean Kemp. Now, for those of you wondering how you do get this card, you do have to complete all-time domination. You actually don't need to complete all three dominations. For those of you that don't know, if you get 33 stars in regular domination, you can jump onto historic, and then once you get 33 in historic, you can go all to all-time, and then you can just skip through all the other dominations and get yourself 8 Kemp if you like. Although I do recommend that you go through historic and get yourself that Diamond Dale Ellis, because that card is an absolute beast as well. But yes, guys, as you can see in front of you today, man, we've got Pink Diamond Sean Kemp. Kemp is always a card I love to use in 2K every year, so hopefully he keeps that up this year, as today we're actually going to be debuting our first gameplay of a card. Now, before we do continue with this video, guys, I want you guys to let me know down in the comment section below, who is your favorite card right now in NBA 2K20 my team and why? Because there's actually so many gems out there to start off the year. I'm curious which cards you guys are repping the most. Let me know down below, as well as if you do enjoy the video, it'd be awesome if you guys leave a like. Let's aim for 1,200 likes, or 1.2k likes on this video. But yeah, let's go ahead, let's dive into these stats, and then we'll hop into a game. Side note, I like the background for the reward cards this year. It just looks so much better. But Kemp is a 97 offensive overall, 92 defense, 6'10", 230, power forward. He does have a secondary of center, but we're going to keep him at power forward for this gameplay. Now, his stats, they're looking really, really good. 80 driving layup for a big isn't bad. Great post game with a nice post fade, nice post hook, great post moves, great draw foul of a 94. I'm liking the mid-range of an 89 and a hittable three-pointer of a 75 as well. The 79 free throw honestly doesn't bug me too much, because this year it's more about timing than it really is about ratings. But he does have that beautiful standing and driving dunk of a 97 and a 96. As we go down, passing and ball handling is nothing we're exactly too worried about, although it is a 62. The defense is looking pretty good though for a big, with the 85 block and the 88 interior defense. Perimeter defense wasn't expecting to be the greatest, and same thing goes for the steal. Rebounding is also really nice. The speed isn't out of this world, but it's better than most cards here to start the game, because most bigs are all in like the lower 70s and 60s speed, so that's honestly not too bad, along with a 63 speed with ball. Usually Kemp is faster with the ball though, so I was a little bit disappointed in that attribute, but it is what it is. Great vertical, great strength, great stamina, great hustle. 53 lateral quickness isn't too bad. Cards are a little bit more balanced this year, you guys will notice throughout the year, and defensively, on the mental aspect, he's looking pretty good defensively and offensively. So top to bottom, attribute wise, he's looking really good. And then when we hop over to the badges, this is a bit controversial, guys, because you grind out all time and then you get a pink diamond that only has 3 Hall of Fame badges. Initially I was upset about that, but then I thought about it and I went to go look at the pink diamond token reward cards, and some of those cards don't even have Hall of Fame badges at all. But he comes with Lob City, Fast Break, Showtime, and then 9 gold badges as well. If I was to say anything, I think he actually needs more gold badges, if anything, not so much the Hall of Fame, and that would make him really nice. But the post spin technician is nice. I like the brick wall as well. All around, he's looking really good, and all around, I'm ready to show you guys my first gameplay. This is gonna be my first time hopping into Unlimited, so I hope everything goes smoothly. But without further ado, let's hop into a game, 2K20 baby, and let's see what the Rain Man has in store for us. Let's get into it. All right, and let's see what our matchup's looking like. That was quite the laggy loading screen. Is that how it usually is for Unlimited? Someone please say no. But he's got Lillard, Eddie Jones, Melo, Tim Duncan at the four, which is going to be a good matchup, as well as Daryl Dawkins at center. All right, Sean Kemp, let's see what you got, man. All right, boys, here we go. Jump ball, artist. Of course, you got to get us started. Sean Kemp, dribble god. Oh, he's not going to play any on-ball defense. That's fine. Sean Kemp to the rim. Nice, easy layup right there to start the game for us. This guy isn't exactly an on-ball defender. He's more of a rim runner, but we got artists there at the rim. You're going to have to do more than rim run if you want to win in 2K20 this year. Get Kemp cutting. Nice pass all the way and almost jumping over Eddie Jones. My gosh. Cards off to a good start. Get back on defense. It's going to go to Melo. I'm stopping that. No rim running today, and he's going to have to shoot some free throws. One thing I've noticed about 2K this year already is it's all about the rim running, man. Nobody wants to do anything else. They want to rim run, and they want to off-ball you at center with George Mirason, man. It's actually crazy. That's a steal right there.
Look at that. You just keep zigzagging and let me know when it works. You just keep zig. How does that go through of all things? Oh, come on, 2K. Gotta be nice to me. And then you know he's gonna be off-balling on the other end. Because the man wants to win. Let's hit him with a nice little pick and fade here from Kemp. Okay, there we go. See, now we got this. Barbecue chicken. Get off me. All the way. Not drawing a foul. We got Artis Gilmore right there to recover for us, though. All right, we got ourselves a tie game right now. I'm not gonna lie, the off-ball's getting a bit annoying, but I just get Kemp to cut right there. Nice pass inside. Easy layup there. And one easy bucket. So if he's gonna off-ball us, we're gonna be attacking. Unfortunately, I don't have my off-ball deodorant playbook just yet, but we'll get it. Nice easy free throw right there, though. It's going down at a 79. Get back on defense. That's good defense right there. Nice rebound. All right, let's push the pace a bit here. Let's go right to Sura. Keep running with me, Kemp. Keep running. All the way to the rim. He's not dunking it, but he's scoring that layup in transition. Card feels fast on the fast break, and you love to see that. One thing I will say is ever since they increased the game speed in this game, it's been so hard to stay in front of people when playing on ball. Sura going right through and putting it down. I gotta get you guys a gameplay with this card because he is filthy. But how are you guys enjoying NBA 2K20 so far? Do you like the gameplay? Do you like the fact that they upped the speed in this game or what? I personally like the slower speed because it was easier to stay in front of people on a fast break. But you know what? Oh, take that out to Gordon. Come on now. That should have been a way easier pass. He misses a shot. Artis Gilmore once again recovering on the boards. This man's got 4 rebounds already. Let's see. Kemp, jab. Oh, he's jumping. Blow by. Hey, how did he stop me right there? Come on now. That should have been an easy blow by from the very beginning right there. So far, we're playing pretty good defense. It's so hard to stay in front of people ever since they upped the freaking speed in this game. He fails at throwing the alley-oop. That was getting exposed right there on defense. Let's go right to Hayward. Hayward is not going to go ahead and shoot it. Not sure why. Kemp is open, though. Easy catch and shoot. Green bean. 4 seconds to go. Let's try to stop him. He's going to take the shot right there. I don't jump there on time. And he hits the shot. You hate to see it, man. But yeah, defense for me, not gonna lie, is the toughest part. I cannot stay in front of people this year. It was easier to stay in front of computers in superstar difficulty than it is to stay in front of players online. I'm not sure if it's my connection or what, but my defense, I've noticed, is really bad. All right, guys, start of the second quarter. Oh, we're staying in front of him there. No chance that shot goes down. You can never be sure with contested shots in the game this year, which is actually kind of tough. Blow right by, get in the post. Let's go right to Kemp. This is Giannis. I'm not worried about a Giannis. Oh, go up. Easy dunk right there to start off the second quarter. Let's get in the post. Get in the post here. Oh, hit him with a post hook. Easy bucket right there. Let's go. You keep off-balling. We gonna keep doing our thing. Look at that. He just wants to drive to the rim. That's not gonna work. Stop rim running, bro. Let's go right to Sura. Snatch back. Artis, go get open. Catch and shoot at the midi. Easy bucket. Keep off-balling me, son. Let's see. Let's get a nice little pick and roll going here with Kemp. He's not going to play any on-ball defense, which really sucks, but Kemp's rolling all the way. We're drawing the foul. That was actually pretty good defense there by Shaq, but we got some more free throws here once again. It's definitely going to be harder to go off with players this year, especially with the way shooting and everything works. You're not going to be hitting every open three like you were in 2K19 and stuff, so it's definitely going to be tough. And also, the off-ball is just going to be super annoying this year. That's not going down at all. Do not give him that. Thank you. Man is just taking any shot he can and hoping it goes down. But to Wade, all the way inside to Shaq. Or not to Shaq. On Shaq, we get the and one with Artis right there. Let's go. Artis Gilmore is also a diamond. I heavily recommend you guys get from the diamond token market. I will be making a video on token market cards you should pick up. But Artis Gilmore, he should be number one. Let me tell you that. I just tried to call a pick and roll and he ran to the basket. What are you doing? We got 4 seconds here. Hit that screen, thank you. Off the dribble, kid. Oh, that's tough. As you guys can see, we've now got the bench in here with Sean Kemp. We're not exactly playing the greatest defense right here. That was an easy pass, easy bucket. I thought we were gonna get blocked right there, but the bench is nice. Jason Kidd's amazing. Dale Ellis is amazing. Hopefully they can do something for us as this guy turns the ball over, trying to rim run some more. One thing I definitely need to improve on in this game though is defense, because all people are gonna keep doing is catching the ball, blowing by you, and scoring at the rim every time. It honestly gets a bit frustrating. That's what I don't like about the fact that they increase the game speed, because it's even harder to guard blowbys because of that. But a nice little pick and roll inside to Sean Kemp. See, this right here should be barbecue chicken. There we go. Easy post hook, easy bucket. Start of the second half here, and then not exactly the high scoring game. Again, he's running to the rim, and it's not paying off for him. But right to Kemp, all the way, not drawing a foul, but he gets the layup right there to go down. But most of my gameplays now aren't going to be as high scoring. The defense is just more intense. You get punished for more dumb shots. It's not like last year again. It's more simulation than ever. Look at him just run to the rim like that and get the bucket. I literally could not stop him right there. It's just so stupid. Cut to the basket. You want an off ball? I got my own kinds of off ball deodorant. I call it cut to the basket cheese when you got those tight defensive settings on Sean Kemp. The best thing about when people off ball in this game is we got all kinds of off ball deodorant. This one, I call the pick and roll off ball deodorant. So hit that screen. I'm trying to throw it up. That didn't work, but I'll take the ball right there and we'll get a bucket. That was a bailout and I'm okay with that. But if you guys honestly have any defensive tips for me in this game, let me know, because I really do not like how you play defense in this game. Good block right there by my squad. Was that my boy Kemp? We gotta reward him. There you go. All the way to the rim. He's going for the layup. I would like a dunk next time, but it's cool. He's chilling under the basket here. Come on, come on. He's jumping. Easy bucket. We're good there. But yeah, the defense is definitely a huge weakness for me in this game. So for you experienced unlimited players, give me some tips, man. One thing I also need to remember this year is I can't really be playing hard with just one player the whole time. I gotta remember to call my timeouts this year or I really suffer. Look at him. He's just taking dumb shots. That's the kind of shots he's been taking the whole game and not getting punished for. Nice pass to Kemp. I gotta see some more dunks. You gotta have higher dunk tendencies than that, buddy. I'm really surprised Sean Kemp doesn't have a slashing takeover yet again. It could be my coach. Once again, back to the pick and roll offense because it is just so consistent this year. It's working. Hit that screen. Now roll for me. He's catching it. See, now we've got this mismatch here. Barbecue chicken. Get in the post. He's going to jump. There's that jump. Easy post hook. Easy bucket. All right, 2 minutes left in this third quarter, man. Let's keep pushing it because our team is playing great. Sean is going to cut right there. Backdoor cut. Easy dunk right there. I love how Tim Duncan plays a little bit too tight, giving Sean Kemp that window every single time. He's missing that second free throw. You love to see it. Ooh, let's go right to Rudy Gay. Should we make his debut? Nah, cut it to Ellis. Oh, man. Now go right to Rudy Gay. Oh, nice backdoor cut again. Easy dunk right there. It's not really hard to go up against off-ball. It depends who they're off-balling with. If they off-ball you with George Mirison, man, it's a wrap. And this guy's calling yet another timeout. And it's just frustrating because he sits through the whole minute. This is the whole minute of my life. I'm never getting back. Ooh, this is going to be a perfect give and go. Inbounds, there you go. All the way through. Or take the shot. That works too. We get the rebound to Rudy Gay. Catch and shoot. Oh, I was really needing that, man. It's times like that where I really wish the shooting was updated just a tiny bit for open shots, man. That's tough. All right, start of the fourth quarter. I'm going to go ahead and try to run a nice little pick and fade here for Kemp this time. We've been running a lot of pick and roll. Let's see if the fade actually works. He's been rolling every time I've called a fade, though. That's the problem. He goes up, still gets the bucket, but it's like the pick and fade is broken. Don't do it, AI. I'm going to send it with Artis Gilmore. What a backboard block. Right to Wade. Easy blow by all the way. Not yet. We're drawing the foul there, and we got some free throws. Man, again, those block animations really be going crazy. And again, Artis Gilmore is a cop, and so is this Dwayne Wade, man. I know I said it in my previous video, but this card, when you upgrade him to an amethyst, he really is worth it. Let's see. Let's go right to Wade. Oh, Kemp's got a mismatch there. There we go. They're probably going to send a double team, but that's cool with me. That's cool with me. Get in the post. Get in the post. Oh, right to Gordon. Catch and shoot, not a green, but it's a bucket. That was a late release too. I'll take that. I see Wade in the corner. Catch and shoot, not a green, but that's a bucket too. And we got ourselves a nice little lead here, man. Don't do it. Don't do it. Welcome to Artis's house. Why don't people ever learn? Right to Kemp. All the way. Putting it down in transition, baby. Get in the post. Let's go to Artis. Pump fake. Out to Kemp. Catch and shoot, not a green. But that one's not a bucket. All right, that's fine. We hit a bunch of threes in a row, so I'll be chilling on that one. Back to Wade. Pump fake. Look who's open in the corner. Catch and shoot. Bang. Oh, you got to hit that. One more time, Kemp. Green bean. Let's go. He's going to pass it inside. Got him. See, that's so baited, bro. I see that all. Dwayne Wade, you want an alley-oop? Oh, apparently not. That's fine, I guess. Let's go to Kemp. Oh, my goodness. Barbecue chicken. We got a barbecue chicken sale again. Hey, I'll take it. We got 132 to go, man. This team, they can't guard me. They can run as much off-ball as they want, but they can't guard me. Pump fake. There we go. Got him. Pump fake again. There it is. Easy ups. Oh, wow. Artis, you're a god. This man has 13 points and 11 rebounds, and it's not even his gameplay. Again. All right, so he's going to go ahead and foul me there, and we got some free throws here essentially to end off this game. What a nice little run we went on. in the second half, though. Looking pretty good. Bob Sura, let's convert these two free throws. This is another really good card. If you guys want gameplay on this man, we've got to hit at least 1.5k likes on this video, because Bob Sura, in my opinion, he's going to be the next point guard that everybody wants. In 2K18, it was Penny. In 2K19, it was like Richie Guerin and basically no point guards at all. But in 2K20, it's going to be this man, Bob Sura. Let's end this game off on a nice little bucket. Kemp, you got the blow-by opportunity right there. All the way. Nah, no finish. He gets his own board. Going back up. Nah, that's tough. All right, so as you guys can see, man, we go ahead and we win this game 72-51. Sean Kemp showing a dominant performance. The defense was showing up really good. The rim protecting everything, man. Let's go ahead. Let's check out the box score. And let's see how our boy Rain Man did. Alright, so as you guys can see, man, Sean Kemp in 20 minutes was given the work. 45 points, 7 rebounds, an assist, 2 steals, and 1 block. Now, I didn't exactly shoot the greatest or as nice as I would have liked. He did shoot 50% from the field, but for a big man, typically you want to shoot at least 65% plus. So, not exactly the greatest. I was forcing some shots towards the end there. I was just looking to dunk and stuff like that, but he did play good. For a card I was forcing shots through for a whole game, he played amazing. 1 for 5 from the 3. The 3-pointers, again, this year, they're a little bit tough to hit. When you're open, when you're not open, they're gonna be tough to hit. So I'm probably gonna have to give him like a shoe or something, because this is a card that's definitely going to stay on my team. But on the defensive end, you guys can see he was playing great. 1 block and 2 steals. Artis Gilmore here, he was trying to steal the MVP from Kemp with 13-13, an assist, 3 steals, 4 blocks, not missing a single shot. Again, this is a card you definitely want to pick up. I'll really bring you guys a raw gameplay in case he didn't debut himself enough right here. But yeah, Sean Kemp is a really good card. I do wish he dunked more, but again, I don't know what the dunk tendencies are like in 2K20, because this was like basically my first unlimited game, so I'll have to use him a couple more times. But my initial thoughts on this card are he's really good. And again, I'm not really bothered by the fact that he only has 3 Hall of Fame badges. I do wish he had Hall of Fame contact finisher, because that's a bit disrespectful to Sean Kemp. But other than that, I just wish he had more gold badges. I'm not mad that he doesn't have like an 80 plus open 3, because this year cards are more realistic. So you don't see cards with just an 80 plus 3 for no reason. And Kemp wasn't exactly a 3-point shooter, so I am perfectly okay with the rating that he has. Free throw was nice. Going to the rim was nice. The post animations were nice. Aside from being off-ball the whole game, we played a pretty good game here with Sean Kemp. Now, is all-time worth doing? In my opinion, yes. Because not only do you just get Sean Kemp, but you also get a Diamond Jerry Stackhouse and a Diamond Bob McAdoo on your way to Sean Kemp. And Kemp, he's going to be a pretty unstoppable power forward in the game right now. As nice as Tim Duncan is, as nice as LeBron is, they're just not going to keep up with his speed to strength ratio, and I think that's where this card really sticks out. But with that being said, guys, this is going to be the end of the video. So as always, guys, if you did enjoy the video, don't forget to leave a like. And for you new viewers, you know you gotta hit that subscribe button and join the Blazion Nation, baby. The 2K20 grind is on, and we come in full throttle. But I want to thank you guys for watching. I hope you all have an awesome day, and take care.